Big Brother Macintosh. Before to start design, let us take some knowledge from named manufacturers with long development history. In this picture you can see Macintosh top-line amplifiers. Let's try to read between the lines. The good amplifier should be powerful, minimum 300 watt and more. I would say 500 watt is optimum. Don't understand me wrong, we are not going to listen it at max power. We need the power to be able to operate in most linear power range far below clipping with solid power headroom. Practically any speaker is able to sustain undistorted music signal at least 4 times to RMS power for a period of time. The worst enemy of speaker is distorted signal, what may create DC component and burn your speaker units. It sounds strange, but a low power audio amplifier is more dangerous to your speaker than high power unit. Macintosh is well-established brand with rather polar forum reviews all around its high-class amplifier. Let us listen to company engineers what they are saying about their products and try to read between the lines.
I'm Charlie Randall. I'm the CEO of Macintosh Laboratories. In 1956, we built the main facility, which is what we're at today. One thing that's unique about Macintosh, the company is completely vertically integrated. Basically, in here is where we process all of our sheet metal, which is anything on the amplifier, pre-amplifier, all the products that you see painted black. That material by itself represents about 1/3 of the cost of the Macintosh product. So it's a very expensive material, but it's also a very highly cosmetic material.
What did we hear? Cosmetic parts comes at 30% of the unit price. And there's nothing about audio. It is all about the jewelry. And this is a million worth question as we spend money on audio quality or amazing designs. Definitely we need both, but could you imagine how good speakers we can purchase for saved money? And let us remember that speakers are 70% of audio quality, maybe even more. Nevertheless, in my opinion, such a large designs will disappear during the next decades. The kilowatt amplifier weight is 70 kilo. It's more than young female weight, and you need 2 persons to move it. 600 watt unit weight is 44 kilos. 300 watt unit weight is 30 kilos. Modern amplifier designs are smaller and lighter. Extra metal parts come with a cost of 30% of the unit price. It's a lot. Actually, metalwork costs there are higher than the total cost of the motor design amplifier. Now let's look at the Bryston top-line Cube models. Bryston is a strong name and I personally like designs and company philosophy. By the specification, this is a state-of-the-art 300-watt amplifier, but it comes with extra cost of metal and efficiency. Look at efficiency parameters in the power section. To deliver 300 watt, we need to provide 700 watt power and dispatch 400 watt of heat. At some point, this design direction is moving to nowhere as well. In my personal ratings, Bryston is the number one name in a high-end amplifier design. This company philosophy about amplifier design and concept is in sync with mine. I'm buying a concept, I'm buying another architecture, and I'm confident that those units will do the job. Am I ready to pay price? No. I want 10 times smaller solution doing the same job. Now let us listen to James Bryston, one of the big names in audio industry.
I'm here with James Tanner Bryston. Good morning.
Good morning, Peter.
Bryston is one of the hallmarks of the high end. How long has it been in business?
We started in the mid-70s, and we were a... Bryston originally was a medical electronics company. And we produced very high-end blood analyzers, where they would have analyzed blood sold to hospitals and such. And my buddy and I, Chris Russell, were into audio in a big way, and we decided we'd use all these very high-quality, high-tolerance parts that we'd use in the blood analyzers and build an amplifier.
Oh, that's cool.
The main difference is this, that most power amplifiers have a power curve. Think about like the torque in your car.
Mm-hmm.
When you there's that sort of point at which everything's working right. You get maximum pull, maximum efficiency. With a power amp, it's typically about 1/3 power.
All right, so James, can you tell us what inspired the development of the Cube series of amplifiers?
The development was by
a young fellow that came to us a couple of years ago by the name of Alexandru, and he had come up with a new circuit that he thought was revolutionary overall. So we invited him to come to Bryston, and he ended up working here for us for a couple of years, and developed a circuit that we felt was an improvement over what we were currently doing in the SST squared, and decided we would move forward with it and call it the Cube. The main difference in the Cube version versus the SST2 version is, in fact, the input stage, this section right here. And that was developed by Alexandru. And it basically has an extremely low distortion relative to what we're currently using. And as a result of that, it's almost 10 times lower overall. Mm-hmm. As a result of that, the input stage is really the main change that occurred. The output stage and the main circuitry within the amplifier remained relatively the same. So it's basically the input section that changed totally to become the Cube version. And we felt it was enough of a difference in terms of the sonic characteristics and the measurement characteristics that we would move to a different product and then develop the new cosmetics to go along with that.
Okay, and so what sonic characteristics can we expect from the new series?
It's different in the sense that the things that sort of matter most to an audiophile tend to be the presentation of the soundstage, the three-dimensional aspect of that. You're sitting there and the instruments and the singers are in the room with you. And I feel that's what the Cube does even better.
Summarizing what we did learn from Macintosh and Bryston. Working away from clipping at one-third of maximum power is a sweet point of any amplifier. Following a good audiophile amplifier should have significant power capability. 500 watts is optimal for majority real-life scenarios to drive 100 watt to 300 watt capable speakers at optimum listening volume. Soft clipping circuits are recommended to protect speakers from distorted signal. Monoblock architecture is part of the high-end amplifier design due to the flexibility to locate amplifier close to the speakers and 100% stereo channel separation. Preamplifier circuits are making a real difference, and it is important to build the good one. It has an influence to sound stage and improved details of the produced sound. James Bryson. Nice fancy appearance, rising costs up to 30% with no impact to sound quality. Macintosh.